फ्रेंड्स, आई अगेन वेलकम यू ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल नेम्ड एज लीगल बिगल, इन विच वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट लीगल टॉपिक्स एंड सेक्शंस ऑफ बीएनएस एंड आईपीसी। सो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सेक्शन 14 बीएनएस एंड सेक्शन 76 ऑफ आईपीसी। फ्रेंड्स, let us see what has been mentioned in section 14 of BNS and section 76 of IPC. Friends, as you know that now the IPC has been repealed and this BNS has come into force since 1st July 2024. So now we will discuss about BNS. Friends, section says act done by a person bound or by mistake of fact believing himself bound by law. Further, nothing is an offense which is done by a person who is or who by reason of a mistake of fact and not by reason of mistake of law in good faith believes himself to be bound by law to do it. Friends, this section is saying that act of a person who is bound by law as directed by law to do something or not to do something, and he himself believes himself to be bound by law to do that act. But further, this section says, firstly says that a person must be bound by law, and secondly there must be an act by that person. There must be an act by that person, and further state that belief that he must believe that his belief is bona fide. His belief must be bona fide and in good faith believes that he is bound by law to do that act. So friends, then friends, this section further clarify the language of this section by example. So example first, a soldier fire on a mob by the order of his superior officer in conformity with the commands of law, he has committed no offense. So section, this example says that a person employed in army with confirmation of his superior officer order, he verify that order, whether that order is legal or illegal, then he fire on the mob. But later on, this is an offense, but he has committed no offense. Why? Because he has worked as per the direction of his superior officer in confirmation that the order of superior officer is a lawful order. Friends, then further this section will be clarified by second example, B. Isme kya hai? But is mentioned in this section, an officer of a court being ordered by that court to arrest by टू अरेस्ट बाई एंड आफ्टर ड्यू इंक्वायरी बिलीविंग जेड टू बी बाई अरेस्ट जेड ए हैज कमिटेड नो ऑफेंस. लेट अस फ्रेंड्स वी विल सी ए. दिस इज द पर्सन डायरेक्टेड बाय द कोर्ट टू अरेस्ट जेड. बट वट हैपन ए आफ्टर ड्यू इंक्वायरी after due inquiry believes himself that this person Y is Z and arrested Y. Then what happened? A has committed no offense because he has acted as per the order of the court after due inquiry and believing himself in good faith that Y is Z. So friends, now I think you have understood this section well as I explained to you. We will discuss section 15 of BNS, Bharatiya Nyay Sanhita. Friends, let us see what section explain. Act of a judge when acting judicial. Act of a judge. If you are going to be a judge or preparing for HGS, then you must have the knowledge of this section. So let us see. Nothing is an offense which is done by a judge when acting judicially in exercise of any power which is or which in good faith he believes to be given to him by law. So friends, this section says that any act of the judge while he is acting judicially in exercise of powers which has been held by him by virtue of his office, then there is no offense. But and other powers which has been given to him by law in exercise of those powers and those authorities, if he done something, then that is no offense. As NB says in the section 15 of BNS and section 77 IPC. Friends, today I am going to discuss you with the three sections of BNS, that is section 14, 15 and section 16, because these three sections are correlated with each other, and therefore I think you will better understand these three sections if you read these three sections or listen these three sections consecutively. So friends, now the section 16 BNS and section 78 IPC but says, listen, act done pursuant to judgment or order of court. Act done in judgment or order pursuant to court. Nothing which is done in pursuance of or which is warranted by the judgment or order of a court, if done while such judgment or order remain in force, is an offense, notwithstanding the court may have had no jurisdiction to pass such judgment or order, provided the person doing the act in good faith believes that the court had jurisdiction. Friends, this section says that any order of or judgment of the court while in force, then any person or police officer as may be act as per the order of the court or judgment of the court, as per order or judgment of the court, in conformity that the court has jurisdiction to pass such order and judgment. In conformity, that the court has jurisdiction to pass such order and judgment, or believes himself in good faith that the court has passed that order in conformity with jurisdiction and in conformity with the power given to that court, act on that judgment and order of the court. Later on, it has came to the notice of that person that or other authority that the court has no jurisdiction to pass such order, then act of that person is a no offense. So friends, in this section, such person has been exempted from punishment. Why? Because he has acted in conformity with the jurisdiction of the court and believes himself in good faith that the court has jurisdiction to pass such order. That is why he is or will be exempted from that act. So friends, these are the three sections. And now one thing I would like to tell you, that order of your parents, master and superior officer is no defense or no excuse in defense, but may be considered at the time jab defense at the time of trial. This is no defense that you have acted as per the order of your superior or parents or master. That is no defense, but it can be considered at the time of passing of quantum of sentence. This defense help you after you will get the conviction from the court, and while court awarding sentence to you, then this will help. But before this, the order of your parents, master, superiors is no defense in the court. You have to act as per your prudence. Otherwise, as you know, that every person is bound to know the law of the country. So you have the knowledge of every law, and if you violate that law, then you are liable to punishment. So let us friend, today we have discussed three sections, and friends, if you are like my these blogs, kindly subscribe me and like my these blogs and support me so I can explain you more and more section in better, and you will get knowledge from me. So friends, milte hain next blog mein.